Europa is one of the four Galilean moons of Jupiter, in addition to Io, Ganymede, and Callisto. It's also one of the most talked about moons, as it has made several headlines over the years for its interesting characteristics discovered through observations from various spacecrafts. A major component in table salt has been discovered on Europa, and there's also the possibility of life being able to survive there. Some even say that there's a better chance of life being found on Europa than there is on Mars. From the size and location of the moon to who actually discovered it, in the video today we're going to take a look at some very interesting facts that you might not know about Europa. Number 9. Age, location, and size. Europa is approximately 4.5 billion years old, around the same age as the planet that it orbits, Jupiter. It is the smallest of the Galilean moons, with a diameter of 1,900 miles. In comparison, Europa is smaller than Earth's moon, but bigger than Pluto. As for its location in our solar system, Europa's average distance from the Sun is around 485 million miles. Since it's the second innermost of Jupiter's moons, it orbits at a distance of about 414,000 miles. To get a better understanding of Europa's distance from Jupiter, Earth's moon has an average distance of almost 239,000 miles away from us. And just like our moon, Europa also has one side that continually faces Jupiter. Additionally, it takes Europa 3.5 Earth days to complete a full orbit around Jupiter. Number 8. Galileo discovered Europa in 1610. On January 8, 1610, Galileo Galilei discovered Europa. That's why the moon, along with the three others, are named the Galilean moons. The famous Italian astronomer used a telescope, which he also designed, to study the three fixed stars, totally invisible by their smallness. He noticed that the stars had changed their positions, and one of them had completely disappeared as it was positioned behind Jupiter. A few days later, he realized that they were not stars, but in fact moons that were orbiting the gas giant planet. Not long after that, he discovered the fourth of the Galilean moons. Of Jupiter's 79 moons, the four Galilean moons are the largest. In fact, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto are some of the largest moons in our solar system, ranking fourth, sixth, first, and third biggest, respectively. Earth's moon is in position 5. Number 7. Origins of Europa's name. According to Greek mythology, Europa was a Phoenician noblewoman and the daughter of the king of Tyre. She ended up being abducted by Zeus, who, in order to try and seduce her, transformed himself into a spotless white bull. After she had adorned the bull with flowers, she got on its back and they rode off to the island of Crete. Zeus transformed back into himself once they arrived on Crete and seduced Europa. She became the queen of Crete, and she and Zeus had many children together. It was the German astronomer Simon Marius who first proposed that the moons be named after the lovers of Zeus. Marius claims that he had discovered the moons prior to Galileo, although it was never proven to be true. Galileo, on the other hand, called the moons the Medicean planets after the Medici family. The moons were officially given their names in the 19th century. Number 6. Extremely cold environment. Europa is made of silicate rock, with an iron core and a rocky mantle quite similar to Earth's. Also, like Earth, Europa is believed to have tectonic plates. This is quite stunning, as it was previously thought that Earth was the only planetary body in our solar system to have a dynamic crust, which scientists say is important in the evolution of life. On the other hand, unlike Earth, it is believed that the rocky interior of Europa has liquid water and/or ice surrounding it that would be as thick as about 50 to 105 miles thick. Europa has a very thick, icy crust that creates a light reflectivity of 0.64, making it one of the most reflective moon surfaces in our entire solar system. It's also very cold, to say the least, as the temperature on the moon's equator does not rise above minus 260 degrees Fahrenheit. It's even colder at the moon's poles, as the temperatures don't rise above minus 370 degrees Fahrenheit. Number 5. Many satellites have studied Europa. Numerous spacecrafts have flown by Europa in order to study the fascinating moon. The spacecrafts that conducted short-term studies on the moon are Pioneer 10, flown by in 1973, Pioneer 11, which flew by in 1974, Voyager 1 in 1979, and Voyager 2 also in 1979. Voyager 2 made the discovery of brown stripes, indicating that there were cracks on the surface of the moon. The Galileo spacecraft conducted a long-term mission of Jupiter and its moons from 1995 to 2003, making the most famous and biggest discovery in the moon's history of a potentially subsurface ocean beneath its icy crust. NASA and the European Space Agency plan to go back to study Europa as well as other moons in the 2020s. The Europa Clipper is scheduled to conduct 40 to 45 flybys of Europa in the 2020s in order to get evidence of the water plumes that have been previously spotted. The Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer, or JUICE, is expected to leave Earth sometime in the 2020s. They're aiming for the year 2022, and it will travel to Europa to search for organic molecules that could indicate life, as well as to determine how thick the crust is. That mission is expected to last at least 3 years. Number 4. Extremely high radiation levels. There's enough radiation on Europa to kill a human in just a single day. With the discovery of water plumes, scientists want to gather more evidence, but that might not be so easy. The high levels of radiation coming from Jupiter's magnetosphere could destroy anything that reaches Europa's surface. Tom Nordheim, who is part of a team from NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in California, said, "When we examine materials that have come to us from the subsurface, what are we looking at? Does this tell us what is in the ocean, or is this what happens to the materials after they have been radiated?" The lander may have to dig into the icy crust to get a better and non-irradiated sample. Depending on where they land on the moon, the drilling depths will differ. For example, the highest radiation levels are at the equator, so if the lander decides to dig for a sample there, it would have to drill between 4 and 8 inches. If it drills in a lower radiation zone like Europa's poles, it would only have to drill down about 0.4 inches to get a fresh sample. This, however, poses a big concern for the spacecraft, as they may get destroyed by extreme radiation if they get too close to the moon. Number 3. Table salt compound discovered on Europa. By using visible light spectral analysis, scientists have discovered sodium chloride on Europa's surface. Table salt is almost entirely made up of sodium chloride, and it's the main component in sea salt. This suggests that the subsurface ocean on Europa may be similar to the oceans found right here on Earth. While it was first believed that the compound discovered on Europa's surface was magnesium sulfate, the high spectral resolution data revealed that it couldn't have been that, since the majority of sulfate salts had certain absorptions that should have been seen, but the characteristics weren't observed. Since sodium chloride can't be detected in the infrared spectrum, scientists conducted tests on ocean salts from Earth that were introduced to the same Europa-like conditions, and they found that the compound turned yellow, the same color that was observed on the visible spectrum. Sodium chloride is a bit like invisible ink on Europa's surface. Before irradiation, you can't tell it's there, but after irradiation, the color jumps right out at you. This was an explanation by the scientist Kevin Hant. This could mean that the moon's ocean floor could possibly be hydrothermically active. Number 2. Subsurface ocean. In the late 1970s and early 1980s, the Voyager 1 and Voyager 2 spacecrafts took pictures of Europa that showed significant and very interesting details. Its surface was brighter than our own moons. There were also several bands of ridges on the surface, and there weren't many craters, mountains, or tall cliffs. All in all, it had a very smooth surface compared to other icy moons in our solar system. The pictures revealed dark icy material that was coming through the open cracks on the surface, indicating that there had been activity at some point. Since the moon is 4.5 billion years old, it should have tons of impact craters on the surface, but surprisingly, there were only a handful that were spotted by the spacecrafts. This suggests that something has erased the craters, and perhaps a layer of liquid water or even warmer ice was present between the crust and the deeper interior of the moon. With that being said, it is now believed that the surface of the moon is only about 20 to 180 million years old. Europa's interior may still be very warm, even to this day, suggesting a subsurface ocean of salty water. Several different research teams noticed possible water plumes jetting to the surface of the moon's south polar region, suggesting that there could very well be liquid water under Europa's icy surface. In fact, NASA revealed that Europa has three pieces of evidence that strongly support a subsurface ocean. According to magnetometer surveys conducted by the Galileo spacecraft, an induced magnetic field close to the surface of the moon indicates that a large body of salty water resides at a depth of 20 miles or less. Second, the ridges, bands, fractures, and multi-ringed impact structures on the moon indicate that there is something mobile below the surface. And finally, the fractures and ridges on Europa are similar to the tectonic plates found on Earth, which suggests that something mobile is allowing the crust to move. Number 1. There may be life on Europa. Since there's a very real possibility that there may be a subsurface ocean, scientists have ranked Europa as being one of the best locations in our solar system to potentially have life. In order to have life, there needs to be three important factors: liquid water, chemical building blocks, and a source of energy. And all three of these things are believed to be present on Europa. A subsurface ocean of up to 100 kilometers or 62 miles deep is believed to exist on Europa, containing dissolved ions, specifically magnesium, sodium, potassium, and chlorine, that many organisms need in order to survive. Ice and other materials that are found on Europa's surface mixed with Jupiter's radiation can create building blocks for life, such as oxygen, hydrogen peroxide, sulfur dioxide, and carbon dioxide. Since the gravitational pull from when it orbits around Jupiter makes the moon have stronger and weaker forces, it creates friction inside of the moon that results in it heating up. The increased and decreased gravitational forces that cause the inside of the moon to heat up could be the reason why the subsurface ocean remains in a liquid form. And since organisms have been found in the subglacial lakes of Antarctica, there's a very real possibility that they could also survive. on Europa. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you actually find out when we put out a new video. Also, for more from me, why not check out my other channel called Biographics? I'm going to link to that below. And as always, thank you for watching.